We're doing it big. Noisemaker TV, I already know what it is. My brother from another. Let's get it. Redskins, DC, Maryland, Virginia, Delaware, New Hampshire, Idaho, Wyoming. You already know what it is. Noisemaker TV.
What's up, baby?
Come on.
Locked.
Nah, man. I love performance. I make the best out of every situation, man. Whether it's an after party or album release party or whatever, you know, like this is what we do, man. I could still be brown bagging it at Giant. Like I've been working since I was 14.
Mm-hmm.
So I've had jobs everywhere, you name it. Giant Food, Foot Action, Chevy Chase Bank, the telemarketer. Like I'm that dude that always had like a job and understood what hard work is. My last job was at Tower Records, you know what I mean? Rest in peace, Tower Records.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So yeah, so I got an opportunity to see how people buy music, you know, how artists come in and, you know, be standoffish and don't wanna and lose fans for life like that. You know what I mean? So, yeah, man, this is what we do, man. So we gotta do it from the Shack in the Wall to the Verizon Center.
Okay. And you've been one of the artists in the game, should I say, to more or less when you got an album out in stores and also to go ahead and do the mixtape game. What kind of like boosts your morale to do as many mixtapes as you have, like, you know, singles, period? I mean, dude, you got like 500 mixtapes.
Yeah, I'm competitive. You know what I'm saying? For those that pay attention, some people may dispute or argue that I'm one of the best in the game at what I do. You know what I'm saying? You know, that I have a lane of my own. You know, that I'm very creative. And, you know, so I'm competitive. And it's almost like doing a mixtape for me, it's almost like practicing, like a basketball player, you know, a sparring, a boxing, a training. Okay. You know what I mean? So I kind of slow down on them now. I do them, I always record. So I always got a mixtape worth of material or an album worth of material. If the phone ring and somebody say, hey, I need XYZ. That ain't nothing. What, it's time? You know what I mean? So I always keep that. But now it's about being more strategic, you know what I'm saying, as a businessman. And, you know, so I may not put out like 2-3 mixtapes a year. I may put out 2. I may put out 1. You know what I mean? I'm more focused in like putting out albums now, like every 8 to 12 months. You know what I'm saying? I have so much music that I want to get out to the people and so many new songs that I want to sing on stage and band ideas and music that I want to experiment and whatnot. But like the whole mixtape thing, man, it's just like sparring. You know, like if I go remake, you know, Maxwell, Alicia Keys, Fire Remake, and I go remake it, in order to remake the record, I got to listen to it over and over again. So then it kind of lets me know, like, okay, wow, this is ingenious, or the arrangements, like, the studying the arrangements and everything. So it's really about learning. It's a learning process, too. Because when you really think about it, like, people be like, man, yo, you killed the Wale Bad joint, man. You smashed that joint, man. They should have used that for the remix, whatever. Really, it's really easy to go in and take a hit record already and make it sound dope. I didn't have to do the hard work. You know what I'm saying? So it's really like, man, you know, it's really like, that's really me saying like, man, that's a dope record. Damn, I wish I'd have did that. Or I wonder what inspired that. Or I wonder how it sounds singing that. Let me go in the studio and see how that sounds. You know what I mean? So it's a learning process for me. It's a creative process, you know, and it's just me having fun. I could be doing something else that ain't so positive.
Right.
Whatever, man. So I'd rather spend that time in the studio, you know, bettering myself, you know, at my craft.
Okay, so word association. I'm going to give you 4 names.
Uh-oh.
And you go ahead and give me 1 word that you can think of off the top.
Uh-oh.
That's associated with these names. You ready?
Yeah.
Let's start with somebody I know that you got a lot of love for.
Is that, you know, in the 90s, we used to have things called interludes. You know what I mean? So with that being said, this is just a segue flow just to keep, you know, keep the vibe going of the album. I like to make a body work you can play from beginning to end. And this is just one of the interludes on the album. It's called Don't Go.
Okay.
I never wanna break you down. I always wanna be around forever. Baby, don't go forever, forever, never. I never wanna leave you be. I want you for eternity.
Coming back as we do word association with him and find out more stuff on the brand new CD. It's called A Place Called Loveland, right here on Noisemaker TV.